Hi, I'm Troy Bailey, and welcome to the Comic Book Movie Collector's Guide, a show about collecting all things superhero cinema. And today, we have a collection update. So what do you say we see what I picked up for the month of April 2021? Let's get into it. Okay, first cabs off the rank. First off, I got Brightburn. I managed to get this on Blu-ray off eBay for $8.30. Now, that's a bit of a bargain there. That one's been sitting around the $12 to $15 mark for ages. And when it came up for what it did, couldn't resist, had to buy it straight away. So that's Burn Bright on Blu-ray. The next Blu-ray I got was Bolt. I managed to pick this one up from one of my local secondhand dealers, Play Hard Gaming, and I managed to get this for $5, so I couldn't resist there either. This one's been sitting around anywhere from $7 to $12, which is surprising. I don't know how this one's been keeping its value for as long as it has. But yeah, I managed to pick that one up for $5, very happy with that. And next off, I got Bloodshot. I managed to get this on Blu-ray off Amazon. They had a bit of a special on at the time, so I managed to pick this one up for $10.85. Couldn't resist there too. That one's been sitting around the 15 to 20 buck mark for a while, so not a bad buy all around for Blu-rays.
I feel like I just heard this. Are they playing this on repeat?
Okay, so next one I have is Inhumans, the motion comic by Jay Lee. Now, this one, I picked this one off eBay for $25. Now, no, that's not a bargain. but I am surprised how hard to get this one is now. Like, this sat at, let's go back a few years, this one was sitting at anything from like $5 to $10. You just couldn't get rid of them. And as usual, you just kind of like, oh, well, I'll get that later. And then all of a sudden, I started looking and the price just went up and up and up and up. And I'm just like, what the hell's going on here? And then getting it here in Australia was seemed to be super hard too. And this fella had it up for $30. I think I managed to get him down to $25 because this is probably the cheapest I was going to get this, surprisingly. So I don't know what happened there. Well, this seemed to go through the roof. But anyway, we finally got a copy, which I'm happy with. So Inhumans, motion comic there. And the next couple I got were The Invincible Iron Man, Volumes 1 and 2. Now, this is the 66 cartoon series. This is all 13 episodes. And I managed to pick these up for $7.38 each. That is a steal. I have seen the collected DVD of these two together in another format from $30 to $40 to even $60. So to get the pair of those for $7.38 each, I was very chuffed. But I managed to have to get them all the way from England, which, this is hilarious. I got one of these. It got inspected for a biosecurity check. It's just a DVD. That was hilarious. I couldn't believe that. Anyway, gotta love COVID, don't you? So anyway, that's Iron Man on DVD. Okay, next one I have for you is Powers Season 1. I managed to get this on DVD off Amazon for $11.69. Now, this one's been sitting around the 15 buck mark for a while now, and when Amazon had a special just to clear out the last one for 11 bucks, couldn't resist. I've already got Season 2, so definitely happy with that. Now I've got Season 1, I can sit down and actually watch this now. The next one is the Robot Chicken Walking Dead special. Now I've got this on DVD off Amazon for $10.74. Now this one's been jumping around like a rabbit on a hot plate. This was like a 20 bucks, then it went down to 8. Should have bought it then. Then it went back up to 15, and then it come back down to $10.74. So I couldn't resist, bought it while I could at a nice cheap price. And the next one I have is Tank Girl on DVD. I managed to get this off eBay for $15. I managed to talk the guy down from 20 down to 15. Very happy with that. It's one of those older, hard to get ones. I was surprised how much this the value of this was keeping. There was anywhere from 20 to 30 to 40 bucks for this, which is quite surprising. So I'm very happy with 15 bucks. So that's Tank Girl on a DVD.
Tank Girl. What's it like knowing you're about to die? You don't miss.
Okay, next one I have for you is Men in Black. Now, I already do own this on DVD, but I don't own this super limited edition special. Now, very surprised to pick this one up from my local second-hand dealer, Play Hard Gaming, and I picked this up for an absolute whopping $2. That's right. Gotta love that shop. $2, and this bad boy has got, look at that, couple of discs, it's got a booklet and all the special features. So for $2, I couldn't argue with that. I thought that'll be a nice little addition. Next one, I got an absolute steal. This is Lois and Clark, The Adventures of Superman Season 4 on DVD. I managed to pick this one up on eBay for $5. That's right, $5. I have seen this bad boy anywhere from $15 to $50. Like, I can't believe how much these still are holding their value. And I managed to snavel this for an absolute steal for $5. Very happy with that, which completed my Lois and Clark now. I already got 1, 2, and 3, so now I've got the full set. Very happy with that. And the next one I got is Stan Lee Presents Mosaic on a DVD. I managed to get this off eBay for $12.55. Now, this is another one that's one of those surprising ones that has been bouncing around for years, and you see it super cheap. Think, oh, I'll get that later, and then as soon as you do go, okay, maybe I'll pick that up, boom, the price seems to shoot up, and this one did, and it was, like, at least here in Australia, very hard to find. But I did manage to pick up a copy, talk the guy down to $12.55, very happy with that. So finally got the Stan Lee Presents Mosaic on DVD.
Maggie Nelson was just an average teenager until an ancient moonstone changed everything.
This is radical.
You're telling me.
Okay, next one I have. Now, these next couple of editions I've got, with the reason why I didn't have much last month is because I was waiting on all of these to come in from overseas. So the first one I've got is The Tick Season 1 on DVD, and I managed to get this for an absolute steal for $9.41 off a guy in England. That, like, postage alone would be $9.41 for us, but somehow he managed to do it really cheap and get it over here. So that's absolute bargain. I've seen this anywhere from $30, $40, $50, like, surprised how much this one's actually worth. But this is the UK release, as you can see, as the US release for some odd reason is missing an episode. So their season 1 and season 2 releases are both missing one episode out of the 13 episodes. Why you would do that, I've got no idea. That just makes no sense. So if you're going to buy them, get these UK releases. This has got the full 13 episodes of the first season, so very chuffed with that one. The next one I've got is Electra Woman and Dino Girl, the complete series from the 70s on DVD. I got this off eBay for $39.90. Now, yep, little pricey there, but you try and find it somewhere else. I think there was only two copies available when I started looking, and there's still, well, there's one now because I got this one, and the other one was about $45. So, yeah, I would say I'm happy because I finally got this, and that completes my Electra Woman and Dino Girl collection. So, yeah, very chuffed with that, but still, I would like to pay a little less. But that is Electra Woman and Dino Girl on DVD. Okay, the next ones I have for you, I got as a bundle together, and that is Roger Corman's Fantastic Four movie, the 1994 one. This is a bootleg, of course. That's the only way you can get it, but a very nice bootleg, I've got to admit. This is fantastic. And Doomed, the Untold Story of the Roger Corman Fantastic Four movie documentary. And I managed to pick both of these up from a guy in the States for $54.65. Not a bad price considering when I've seen a lot of these packs, or individually anywhere from $30 to $40 each. So to get the pair of them for $54 and ship from the States, can't really complain. I've been wanting to get these for a while. So very happy with that. Can't wait to sit down, So keep an eye out. I'm going to have a future review of both of these. So yeah, can't wait to sit down and watch those again. So that is Roger Corman's Fantastic Four and Doom, the Untold Story of the Fantastic Four movie.
This version of the Fantastic Four really was doomed.
Okay, thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this episode. And of course, let me know in the comments down below whether you picked up any of those titles for your collection, or if you managed to pick yourself up a good bargain on one of those as well. Now, if you did enjoy this episode, don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, and notification buttons, as it really helps the channel out. And I really do appreciate it. Thank you very much to you and everyone who's already done it. Now, if you want to contact me, you can email me at thecomicbookmoviecollector@gmail.com. And of course, you can also hit me up on the socials at Comic Book Movie Collector on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. All the links will be down below. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.